There was a boy sitting across the table from me, reading a book on mathematics. I could see the equations and symbols. I saw him walking around earlier that morning, very tall and gangly, sandy-haired, only about 18 years old. I later learned he was a champion chess player and spoke 7 languages. He was a genius, I guess. His parents had him committed, he told me, but he didn't say why. He didn't seem to mind. He was quiet and good-natured and always busy doing something. When he saw me looking at him, he asked if I wanted to play a game of chess, and he brought out his board. I showed him what I had just wrote. He looked very thoughtful and said, "I don't have time to hear everything, but I'm interested in music and keep abreast of what's happening. It's odd you say you haven't been productive. It seems to me you have several. Let's see," and he counted in his head, "I'd say 6 or 7 albums that came out last year. That isn't bad." I was amazed, but he was right, and I realized last year seemed like 10 years ago to me. He checkmated me 3 times in a row, and I could see he was getting bored, so I went back to my bunk and tried to write some poetry. A good title came to my mind. "Nice of you to have come to my funeral. Oh damn it all, blues. Screwed to the melting frozen rock. But dared to embrace stone. Concrete hard. Imagine soft. Only to overdo erections of loneliness that turns feminine and speaks back wet, warm tears not too far removed from its common denominator. Iced urine melting at dared hot death that clings to life for love with thought of some response, be it only the clay, dirt, or pavement I behold in my drunken, fevered search for a true woman's groin, wanting me as I want her, to never hate me because we found refuge of satisfaction, as 2 drunken stones warm themselves side by side, in outside our guttered ideas of opposite sides fucking. Do you understand that poem, Dr. Wallach? Well, Charles, it certainly is a very personal expression."